express my deepest gratitude and thanks to the Punjab Judicial Academy. My thanks are also directed to Mr. Amar Meer. This academy is doing wonderful job, very wonderful job indeed. हमें उन्होंने मौका दिया इधर आए फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम 12 साल में इधर अकेडमी में फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम पहली दफा आया हूँ फेडरल जुडिशियल अकेडमी के बाद. दिस इज फर्स्ट चांस आई एम हियर. माय टॉपिक इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ फेयर ट्रायल. द टॉपिक अपीयर्स टू बी वेरी सिंपल बट दैट इज नॉट दैट मच सिंपल कि हम इसको इतना लाइटली लें. The other thing is that this topic has catapulted me into the past memories. Get back to 2002 when I assumed charge as civil judge at Multan. I will share these memories later on. First of all, we come to our topic. ये इंसाफ की मूर्ति है, allegorical personation of the moral forces in judicial system. Lady Justice symbolizes three things. Set of scales, she is holding three things. Set of scales, sword and blind hold on her eyes. The scale, upon scale she measures the strength of a case, court and opposition. Sword in her left hand symbolizes the power of reason and justice. The third thing, the blindfold represents objectivity and impartiality. Now let's move to the introduction. The right to fair trial is a norm of international human law designed to protect individual from the unlawful and arbitrary curtailment of liberties and freedom, the most prominent of which are the right to life and liberty of the person. Now the question is, what is the minimum criterion of fair trial? What constitutes, what is a fair trial? Fair means appropriate and just. What is just? Just is what is acceptable according to the core values, human values and collective conscience of the humanity. The minimum standard of the rights of the accused include the natural justice, principles of natural justice. It must be based on principles of natural justice. Those are, no one should be condemned unheard, the due process of law, and the third one is, no one should be judged in his own cause. And while talking to other rights, उसमें एवरी अक्यूज्ड शैल हैव द राइट टू बी प्रिज्यूम्ड इनोसेंट अंटिल प्रूवन गिल्टी अकॉर्डिंग टू लॉ. ऑल पर्संस शैल बी इक्वल बिफोर द कोर्ट्स. द राइट टू बी हर्ड बाय अ कॉम्पिटेंट एंड इंडिपेंडेंट एंड इम्पार्शियल ट्राइब्यूनल और कोर्ट. द राइट टू पब्लिक हियरिंग. वी विल एलिबरेट सम ऑफ दी पॉइंट्स लेटर ऑन. First of all, we are going to see, we are going to learn and we are going to revise what are the principles which are to be applied and which are to be seen at the time of conducting the trial. The right to be heard within a reasonable time. Here, justice must not be delayed. The right to counsel. This is one of the most recognized right in human species. Broadly speaking, the fair trial principles can be divided in three stages: pre-trial rights, hearing rights, post-hearing rights. When we talk about pre-trial rights, those include prohibition on arbitrary arrest and detention. The first one has been enshrined in our constitution, in Assam. First right is prohibition on arbitrary arrest and detention. Those have been derived and borrowed from the international conventions and human rights bodies. This principle has been enshrined in Article, I think, 10 of the Constitution. Right? which makes our constitution and procedural law and bring them at par with the international level of trial. The second thing is right to know the reasons for arrest. हर बंदे को हक हासिल है उसे बताया जाए कि उसको क्यों उसको अरेस्ट किया जा रहा है, उसकी लिबर्टीज क्यों कर्टेल की जा रही है. थर्ड वन इज राइट टू रिमेन साइलेंट. नो वन कैन बी शुड बी कंपेल्ड टू कन्फेस और टू स्पीक अगेंस्ट हिज ओन सेल्फ. दिस थिंग हैज बीन रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय द यूनाइटेड स्टेट ऑफ अमेरिका इन अ केस कॉल्ड मिरांडा केस, मिरांडास. Now this is called Miranda rights. Miranda versus state of Arizona. The case was wonderfully authored, in which changed the history, course of history, and the amendment was brought into the American Constitution. The right to legal counsel, the right to prompt appearance before the judge to challenge the lawfulness of arrest and detention within reasonable time. I think Article 12 or 13, it can have the shortest 24 hour magistrate is on the patient of the provision of torture during pre-trial detention, provision on incommunicado, provision on incommunicado detention means ke kisi ko हम ऐसे अरेस्ट करके उसको सॉलिटरी कन्फाइनमेंट नहीं ले जा सकते, उसको कम्युनिकेशन उसकी नहीं रोक सकते, वो किसी से बात ना कर सके, अपने कोसर से बात ना कर सके, उससे बिल्कुल इनकम्युनिकेटो कर दिया जाए. इक्वालिटी ऑफ आर्म्स, ये एक नई बात है. आई वुड लाइक टू लेबोरेट ऑन इट एंड आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क माय वन ऑफ सम ऑफ माय फ्रेंड, एनी ऑफ माय फ्रेंड हु कुड स्टैंड अप एंड लेबोरेट दिस पॉइंट. इक्वालिटी ऑफ आर्म्स व्हिच मस्ट बी ऑब्जर्व्ड थ्रू द ट्रू द ट्रायल. Equality of arms. Any of one of my friends? Okay. It means both the parties should be given equal opportunity before the court. ये नहीं है कि हम दही को तो दे रहे हैं, चार साल दे रहे हैं, तो वो अपनी एविडेंस लाए और जब when it comes to defendant, तो हम उसको दो होते हैं, उसका rank close करते हैं. This is unfair. This is against. This is not equality of arms. These principles I have picked down for collected and noted down from the help of my friends and from the national instruments and from the local national level instruments enactments